Assalamu alaikum and hi. My name is Mama Airie Haqim bin Smaluddin. So today our group members and I will present about the rise and fall of management accounting article. So why the management accounting rise and fall? Firstly, the management accounting reports are of little help to operating manager attempting to reduce costs and improve productivity. Frequently, the report decreases productivity because they require operating manager to spend time trying to understand and explain reported variances that have little to do with the economic and technological reality of their operation. Management accounting systems do not provide timely and detailed information on the process efficiency, or they focus too narrowly on inputs such as direct labor that are relatively insignificant in today's production environment. So the system not only fails to provide relevant information to the manager, but it also distracts them from noticing the key factors important for production efficiency. Second one is the management accounting system fails to provide accurate product costs. Costs get distributed to product by simplistic measure, usually direct labor based, that do not represent the demand made by each product on the firm resources. The standard product cost system, which are typically of most organizations, usually lead to enormous cross-subsidiary cost product. Many firms seem to be falling victim to this trap. So the third one is the manager erosion contract to the short-term cycle of their monthly profit and loss statement. The financial accounting system treats many cash outlay as expenses of the period in which they are made, even though this outlay will benefit the future period. So the short-term profit pressure can lead to a decrease in investment for the long run. There could be many valid short-term measures that would be appropriate for motivating and evaluating the managerial performance. Nowadays, the management accounting system provides a misleading target for managerial attention. They fail to provide the relevant set of measures that appropriate reflect the technology, product, process and competitive environment in which the organization operates. Next is the article stated some challenges such as rapid progress in product and process technology and wide fluctuation in currency exchange rate and raw materials price demands excellence from corporate management accounting system. So to resolve the challenges, an organization management accounting system must provide timely and accurate information to facilitate effort to control costs, to measure and to improve productivity, and to devise improved production process. The management accounting system also needs to report accurate product costs so that pricing decision, introduction of new product, and response to the appearance of rival product can be made with the best possible information on product resource demand. Finally, the large decentralized organization requires the system to motivate and evaluate the performance of their manager. This system should provide appropriate incentive and signal to manager working in different functions or departments. The organization management accounting system serves as a vital two-way communication link between the senior and subordinate manager. An excellent management accounting system will not by itself guarantee success in today's economy. So the success depends on the product that meets the customer needs, on efficient production and distribution system for this product, and on effective marketing effort. However, an ineffective management accounting system can undermine even the best effort in product development, process improvement, and marketing policy. With an effective management accounting system, the best outcome occurs when the management understands the irrelevance of their system and bypass it by developing personalized information system. But danger lurks in management do not recognize the inadequacy in their management accounting system and rely on it for managerial control information and product decision.
Assalamualaikum and hi, my name is Izzani and I will be covering two subsections in this presentation. First, the opportunity, and the second, the management accounting rules. firstly, the opportunity. The need for management accounting system is growing at a time when information gathering, processing, analysis and reporting are becoming more affordable. As a result of the direct management of many industrial processes by digital computers, information may be captured in real time for operational performance analysis. Virtually, every transaction may be recorded in highly automated systems for the later examination. Today, sophisticated algorithms can precisely monitor and identify the resource demands that each product in a broad product range makes. It is possible to calculate and provide timely and relevant management performance measurement throughout the company. Modern management accounting system designers may create reporting and control systems that are more precise, timely and effective than those created by the predecessors because to modern electronic technology. Basically, this advancement makes the management accounting much easier and reduces the time taken for the work of management accounting. So, moving on to the second subsection of my presentation, which is the management accounting rules. Accounting in general can be dated back to approximately 500 years ago, when Kaplan described the basics of a well-functioned double entry bookkeeping system. However, the demand for management accounting seems like a new concept dating back to 19th century. Early in the 19th century, there were no level of management, meaning to say that the owner or entrepreneur only needed to generate more cash from the business to pay off their suppliers and purchase raw materials. Fortunately, this situation has altered because of the Industrial Revolution. Due to economic of scale, owners started investing enormous sum of money and recruiting long-term employees. Instead of paying out ongoing business via market transaction, this technique enabled organizations to make money. Roads, steel factories and textile mills all shown their feasibility. Conversion process was the pivotal change of demand in management accounting information. Hierarchical organizations started creating measures to track the efficiency of converting labor and raw materials into finished products. Therefore, management accounting was developed to enhance profit-seeking activities in hierarchical organizations. It focused on conversion costs and product summary measures. The aim was to identify the cost and measure its efficiency. In the mid-19th century, advancement in technologies provided hierarchical organizations to improve management accounting system. It could coordinate acquisition of raw materials and distribution of final products over large geographical areas. It allowed for a decentralized system to be developed, providing necessary coordination, distribution, and logistic activities. The best example provided in the article was Railroad Corporation. They were the largest enterprises at the particular moment, which a comprehensive system was needed to oversee the diverse and complex operation. New procedures were invented to control cash disbursement and oversee extensive internal operation and performance. Ratios were developed to measure the enterprise's profitability. Additionally, the Industrial Revolution and the improvement of technology together helped firms like Marshall, Sears and Woolworth grow. The merchant used new materials to monitor the effectiveness of the management and control strategy. These metrics emphasize selling, pricing and buying operation. Both the gross profit margin and the inventory stock turn were employed at the same time. Those were the examples provided in the article. Management accounting was developed to expedite management process type industry. It had very little to do with profit seeking motive. This was due to the reason that it was designed to focus on the conversion of raw materials into final products in a sustainable method, which was believed to deliver profit in long term. This promoted efficiency to key operation and management accounting, operated independently to financial accounting. The push towards scientific management was consistent with further management accounting improvement. Frederick Taylor began this movement in 1880 with the intention of increasing the effectiveness and use of labor and resources. The price of final item was calculated by adding the expenses of labor and materials. These expenses caused price fluctuations, which were reflected in the sale price. As a result, the cost was more closely related to replacement cost than to historical cost. The computation was solely required internally, not for external usage. Lastly, we have reached the last development stage of management accounting. It took place in the early 20th century and designed to assist diversified organizations. The most notable organization associated with it, according to article, was DuPont Powder Company. The organization faced hectic problem of coordinating diverse activities, which resulted in effective decision making. Therefore, budgeting and operating activities were designed by senior managers to overcome the issues. The best example was innovation of return of investment. ROI dealt with capital allocation to yield the highest efficiency, although it was only mainly used by top managers. The use of ROI greatly increased in 1920, and decentralization became a crucial component of an organization operation. This was primarily caused by corporate growth, which covered a wide range of product areas. In order to handle the transition, new policies and procedures were required. At the same time, ROI was crucial in enabling managers to control capital input and oversee their different diversion. This task of providing funding for particular different activities in their respective department was now assigned to managers. Now I will pass on this presentation to Amirul Afiq. Thank you.
Hi, I am Muhammad Amirul Afiq, and I'll be explaining the subsection of loss relevance. By 1935, virtually all management accounting practices that are practiced today have been developed. Some of the practices are cost accounts for labor, material and overhead, budget for cash, income and capital, flexible budgets, variable analysis, transfer prices and divisional performance measures. These practices first come to exist to serve the information and control needs of the managers due to increasingly complex and diverse organization. However, the pace of innovation seemed to stop in the mid of 1920. Next, we are going to talk about what are some typical examples of problems caused by the failure of management accounting system to provide relevant data for management planning and control decision. Among the significant problems includes misdirect marketing efforts that result from poor information about the profitability of a company's diverse product, inability to manage overhead costs, a misplaced emphasis on cost-cutting program as the way to increase productivity, the use of modern flexible machining system to produce standard parts in high volume and not custom parts in small lots, and underinvestment by manufacturers who fail to consider the full strategy of consumer-based investment in computer-aided production system. Among all the listed problems, the most basic one is no multi-product organization knows how much of each products that they manufacture cost. They only rely on cost accounting system, which is the only system for estimating product cost. Today's system does a bad job of tracing consumption of indirect or overhead costs to products. Furthermore, the large cost categories of marketing, distribution, and engineering support may not even included in the product or product line. The system also provides misleading targets for manufacturing managers. This is proven by operating managers frequently make an excessively large batch size production so that they can have favorable volume rises in high labor and machine utilization measures. They produce inventory that cannot be stored easily and sold is not evaluated. Even with no significant innovations in the organizational forms, manufacturing process continue to increase in the decades after 1920. This makes the need for accurate product cost and effective process control must be imposed anyway. Now let's move on to the next topic, which is academic letter spray. This topic revolves around why researchers fail to note the growing obsolescence of organization management accounting system and why did they not play a more active or stimulative role to improve the art of management accounting system design. It is believed that academics were led astray by focusing too narrowly on a simplified model of a firm behavior influenced strongly by economists' one product, one production model of the firm. Management accounting economists found little value in the cost allocation imposed on organization by financial accounting procedures. Years of literature emerged advocating the separation of costs into fixed and variable components for making good product decisions and for controlling costs. This literature very persuasive when illustrated in simple one product settings used by economists, academics and accountants, but never fully addressed the question of where fixed costs came from and how does these costs need to be covered by each of the products in corporation. Ironically, as management accounting system became less and less relevant and less representative in companies' operation and strategy, senior executives taking over the company with the belief that they could run the company by the numbers.
My name is Nazhan and I'll be talking about accounting for caravans and innovation. So, for this section, the writer emphasizes on the historical track of management accounting to show that the thing we've been discussing earlier on in this presentation was not a new phenomenon. It started back in the 15th century since the publication of the infamous original accounting book by Fra Pacioli. He's an Italian. So the story basically is about the early days of trading goods in Venice, Italy, with other countries. So frankly speaking, the standards back then was not as complete and thorough as of now as what we have today. So we may have noticed few distinctions of how do we account certain items. So back to the story. The traders from Venice brought all their goods they gained from the northern Italy and sell them in India. So once they were all sold, they went back to the Italy while bringing back some tea stocks for them to be traded there in Venice. So in order to calculate the profit gain, the accountant back then, that time, decided that they had to subtract the cost of caravan and other initial acquisition costs in order to find the profit figure before dividing them between the investors. However, the question that comes to my mind, and also to your mind, and also to the writer's mind, in modern view, is that was there or were there any regulations to compute the quarterly report of the expedition in that particular year, 1487? Where most of the time, back then, they spent a lot in traversing across continents and countries. Especially in the article, it says, in the third quarter, where the traders traveled across the Persian desert. So to take into consideration, everything was slow, at slow pace back then, right? So the way they commuted from one place to another consumed a long time, longer time than what we have today. So to them, in order to calculate profit for the expedition in that particular 3 months is not worth it, and it is not a meaningful exercise. But somehow in today's world, it's already a norm to prepare monthly and quarterly report, right? But it is not to say that this method is arguably meaningless to see the short-term progress. But as we coming back to the Venetian story, they actually could also do the monthly and quarterly report and whatnot, but they didn't do, right? They had many methods, many potential methods, which were the distance route, the condition of the inventory being transported, the amount of provision left, and many more. So why they did not think of any? You answer it. So to take that into to this point of view, there are actually many better indicators to see in the short-term progress of an organization rather than depends on the quarterly earnings. And yes, cash flow is actually important to see the patterns of cash with cash receipts and cash expenses, but they are relatively different than working hard to produce the quarterly income statements because of the amortization and any other equals as according to the article. And next we have the innovation. So this article states that the management accounting should have robust changes to make it relevant over time. The system is said to be designed to be supportive with the business operations and strategy for better financial forecast. So how do we do that? Through effective, according to the article, it is through effective experimentation and communication where we may find the solution due to better acknowledgement. Other than that, we also may have creative managers and academic researchers to develop a new concept of management accounting system that we might never think of. In conclusion, as we back into the introduction, does this management accounting method of short term will remain relevant in the future, or does it really help to see the performance of the organization with that quarterly report? So if there is a little to no further to this action, we most likely fail to show the actual or more accurate financial information in decision making for the long run. With that being said, thank you very much.